Settle down, take it easy, good Republicans of Brighton and Hove. It's another thrilling show just for you.
Just for you.
Indeed, isn't it, Deb? Nice to see you.
And you too.
You sure?
In the second half of the show, we are talking to Veronica Blackley, so stay tuned for that. But don't leave us now either.
Why would you?
Why would they?
How would they leave us now? Stay.
Stay.
Because we have...
We have a returning guest.
He came back.
Not many people do, but he did. And so we'd like to welcome Toby Moore from Content Club. Hello, Toby.
Hi,
lovely
guys.
To see you.
Nice to be back in the Republic.
Yes.
Fantastic. Nice to see you.
So what's the update? What are you going to tell us? Tell us a bit about Content Club and other things you've got coming up. Tell us everything.
Content Club has been doing all sorts of exciting things. Actually, I took some time off because I had a little baby. She's 5 months now. But I'm back in the swing of work now. And
brilliant.
Organising lots of events and things.
So for our viewers who don't know what Content Club is, can we just have a quick
sentence? So Content Club has been running it for 2 years now, mm-hmm. and it's a community for digital makers, movers and shakers.
Well, hey.
Practising that one.
I've heard a jingle.
Digital makers, movers and shakers, love it.
But it's essentially a community and a group mm-hmm. for any people working in digital marketing, creative mm-hmm. roles, or people running their own businesses and having to do marketing mm-hmm. for themselves. And we basically, it's all free to access kind of skills, knowledge, network, community, that sort of thing. And we do like 3 or 4 events a month now.
A month? Okay.
Some are quite big events, some are quite smaller, just sort of like socials in the pub and networking type mm-hmm. stuff.
Well, so you say marketing, you're marketing the businesses.
Absolutely. So it's particularly become mostly just through a sort of natural progression mm-hmm. for people that are having to market their own businesses. Mm-hmm. And if it's not like their first or second skill.
You can't
really afford to pay thousands of pounds a month for an agency or something. Like, we just try and give people the skills to do it themselves.
Excellent.
But we have 2 massive events coming up in October.
Please.
I'd love to tell you about.
Please.
Sorry, we haven't got time.
See you later. Today.
We've run out of time.
Sorry.
So last time I was here with you guys, we were talking about TEDx Brighton.
Yes.
Of course, that's coming up again at the end of October.
Excellent.
And then in between now and then, we also have a conference called Grow 19.
Okay.
Which is, again, for marketing people or people running their own businesses and needing their own marketing. So
Grow 19?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's
in
taking...
2019.
Right,
it's in 2019.
Yes.
But it's on the 16th of October, 2019.
So that's what year it is. He still thinks it's the 70s. Yeah. Look how he's dressed.
Nobody's
so Grow 19 is in 2019, is in the year. I'm sure all of our viewers got that. So tell us about Grow 19. So it's on the 16th of October.
It is, yeah. And we sort of... I'm running it with Social Brighton, who are another sort of marketing company based in Brighton. Really nice guys. And... we've just been really struggling with helping people get over the same hurdles with mm-hmm. basically marketing their own businesses. Mm-hmm. And also, like, if you look around Facebook and Instagram and stuff at the moment, there's just so much kind of bad and almost like borderline malicious advice out there for people. And we just really want to try and create an event that acts as an antidote to that.
Okay. When you say malicious, what do you mean?
I think in the last couple of years, there's a sort of like a digital epidemic, if you like, of all of this sort of like pyramid scheme style selling around digital marketing, Facebook adverts, Amazon selling, all of this sort of stuff. And I think it's giving, it's a really difficult thing for people to kind of get their heads around in terms of, is this a good thing for me, a bad thing for me? But also, it's starting to give people in marketing a bit of a bad name as well.
Never.
God forbid that we deserve that. I just think there's a really difficult wrapper mm-hmm. sort of being put around people working in marketing now because of these sort of messages coming through.
Can I just say, can I be controversial now? Because marketing is known for being a bit dishonest.
Yeah. Yes.
What makes you any different? Why are you...
The words that we've been really sort of focusing in on and trying to bring forward as a part of organising Grow, and this is from like the communities mm-hmm. that we've been supporting, like this is not something that we try and invent, this is something that comes from them, mm-hmm. is positivity and authenticity.
Right.
And I think, you know, a lot of the guests that come on on this show are like local businesses that have created something that they care about,
important
to them, and actually then giving themselves the very best opportunity of connecting with people that can help that grow. Like, that's an important thing.
Definitely.
You know, that's important for our economy. It's important for them as business owners, with people with ideas and so on. So actually just giving people the tools to kind of like, do you know what you do? Like, if you talk about it honestly and authentically, and you take out a really sort of, you take really positive skills into the world with that in terms of marketing and so on, like you're not going to become Facebook or a millionaire maybe, but at least you'll get to live the life that you want through the business you create.
That's the idea,
and that
isn't
is the goal,
it?
Yes.
Those
isn't it?
Are the really important skills to share with people.
That's right. Mm.
So with Thrive 19, so where...
Grow 19.
Grow 19, so we had the...
Oh, you got it wrong.
Grow 19, so I'm getting confused.
It's obviously Grow 19. Yeah.
Grow 19.
19 because of the year.
Sorry, I apologise. So Grow 19, is it the first one?
It is the first one.
So this is the inaugural event. And how can people access it? Anyone watching one of
the... So the website's growevent.com. And we've got Facebook and Instagram channels as well that you can check out, and tickets are affordable, I think. Latest, I think.
You say?
We'll be the charge of that now. Yeah.
But I think an important part of all of this is to make these things accessible and affordable. It's a big part of the ethos behind these events and the communities and so on. So, yeah, it's about £30-40 a ticket. Latest TV10 gets you 10% off. As a promo code, and actually we just really want to try and attract as many people that value positive and authentic ways of selling and marketing what they do.
How do you spot if they're authentic though?
That's a really good question. I think a lot of that comes down to observing how people talk about and sell what they do. I think people that do come from a really honest and authentic place, like value building trust with people before they even try and sell. And I think this is a real important essence of what makes a good business. You know, you've had the Good Business Club on recently as well, and like and all of these are values that kind of get lived and breathed through communities and businesses like that.
We have obviously a lot of local businesses on here do actually feel the genuine I think it's a feeling, gut feeling. You talk to them. And you think,
you know when you're being sleazy sold to.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And like, and the way that you get around that is by sort of clarifying the importance and validating the skills and the behaviours that come with being trustworthy and honest and selling to people that are right and relevant.
Sure.
But the thing is you say that you can tell, and most people can.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, the less honest in that group, you know, they do sort of prey on the more sort of vulnerable.
And I think that comes back to what I was talking about earlier about this kind of like digital epidemic, if you like,
exactly.
All these things, because there's the thing that I've discovered, particularly through Content Club, is that there's two different kinds of ways of selling or ways of creating an audience, and one is by selling to people's vulnerability and their fears, and one is by selling to their ambition and their success.
Absolutely.
Yes, perfect.
That's a lovely way of putting it.
Yeah.
No, that is, and I think, you know, that's, yeah.
So this makeup company going, you don't need the makeup.
I'm going to buy it all.
You know, where does that come from? You know, is it selling makeup because you want to churn out, you know, millions of pounds a year selling tat, or is it because you want to create something that's empowering for men and women?
Exactly right. That's good.
Absolutely. So that's Grow 19.
Yeah.
Tell us about
TEDx. Yeah. What was I thinking? Organising these two events in October.
Tell us about TEDx, because that's a big old thing, isn't it?
Yeah, we've been running it a long time now. This is my seventh year on TEDx, and every year just gets slicker and slicker in terms of how we do it. So, yes, it's on the 25th of October, and we've got, I think, just over 20 speakers and performers booked this year.
Any hints as to who?
We're slowly but surely drip feeding this. I mean, we've got about a dozen on our website at the moment.
Okay.
I'm really, really pleased to say that we have more women than men speaking this year, which is a big thing in terms of like managing the diversity of speakers and messages and so on. So
was that intentional, or is it just turned out?
No, I think, I mean, in terms of actually creating a diverse set of speakers, that's something that I try to improve as a part of the creation process every year. What I've learned this year is that the process that we go through is a very outbound process. You know, we create a story and a narrative for the day, and then we go out and research and find the speakers to fill those gaps. And because of the nature of like the way that the kind of the history of the workforce is created, like if you just Google experts in whatever field, you tend to get sort of middle-aged white guys, you know
yeah.
what I mean?
Yeah.
And you have to kind of scratch below the surface
yeah, exactly.
of the top Google results to find
yeah.
people that are actually doing really meaningful work in, mm-hmm. in smaller niche parts of those mm. industries and markets and social spaces mm. and so on.
Yeah.
And they're there.
And they have a lot of valuable things to say.
Absolutely, more valuable things
to share.
They
exactly.
have more valuable things to share because exactly. their experiences are more unique.
As a middle-aged white guy, I can say we know nothing.
Yeah, I'm on my way to say.
I know nothing. I know nothing.
Well, that we know.
Yeah.
So I think what we would love to do is we would love to share all of the details
yeah.
of your events on our Facebook
Your many
page.
Events.
Your many
yeah.
events.
So what's the first one?
The first
one's 16th, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, 16th of October is Grow 19.
Grow 19.
So if you're a small business and you're doing your own marketing, so on, we'd love to see you there.
Brilliant.
TEDx is if you're anyone that
yes.
loves to be inspired and loves to have a wicked time.
We talk to.
And loves to walk away from a day just feeling energised and motivated and full of beans.
And it's number 7, so it's quite exciting. You've got one...
It's actually number 9.
Number 9!
Yeah, and,
9's a very positive
and
number.
TEDx Brighton's, TEDx is a thing that's only been running for 10 years,
yeah,
so we're
excellent.
One of the longest running TEDs now.
Brilliant. Brilliant. Thank you so much. We're going to have to go to some adverts now, but thank you for coming in. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you in
see
part
you in a
two.
Bit.
Thank you very much.
Welcome back to the People's Republic of Brighton Hove.
That's the ident.
Thank you.
It's brilliant.
I did that to please him.
Yes.
Are you pleased?
I am now.
Thank God.
People's Republic of Brighton Hove.
I'm here to please you, Andy.
And if you would like Jason to please you too...
That sounds weird, sorry.
Then send us a note and we'll send him round.
I'm only 74. Got me own teeth.
Oh, dear.
Anyway, talking of pleasing...
Pleasing? Oh, gosh, yes.
That was a bit of a segue.
That's a brilliant segue because it's a delight.
It is.
Absolute delight.
Living hell.
We've got Veronica Bradley. What's the matter?
I don't know. I'm overheating. My shirt's gone red.
With that introduction, would you care to join us?
I have that effect.
It's lovely to have you back on the show.
I know.
Last time you came and you
came back as well.
Yeah. This is a return show. You know, we're now sort of on the cheap end of the. No, we're not.
Recycling people.
We're green. The show.
Next week we've got XR coming in. We've got XR coming in now. Talk about recycling.
Oh.
Meanwhile.
I don't like that segue.
No,
recycling me.
Hold on.
Okay.
Now, Veronica was here last time talking about her burlesque courses.
Okay.
She's now got this fabulous show going on, Showlesque, which it would be lovely to invite you to tell everyone about.
Yeah, you should come.
I will.
You came.
I came along.
He was very pleased.
Oh, he was great.
Literally sat
he was pleased.
In front, yeah. smiling all the way through.
We're here to please Andy, obviously.
It's all about pleasing.
It is.
Everyone's pleasing everybody, which is fantastic.
Excellent.
How can you please our wonderful people in the room?
Well, it's great. It's a new weekly Saturday night cabaret, burlesque and circus show. And it's held at the Walrus, which is on Ship Street in Brighton.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really cool because it's this lovely... intimate venue. It only seats about 60 people, but it's big enough so you're not squashed, but small enough so it's cosy.
Intimate.
Very intimate.
It's a basement.
It's the basement down
yes.
at the Walrus, yeah.
It's
the
really
Walrus
nice,
is this
yeah.
amazing
yeah.
venue.
Yeah.
You walk in there, it's like a really cool pub. Upstairs, they've got this gorgeous restaurant,
yeah.
and downstairs, you've got the Walrus Club, which we take over for a few hours.
You say circus.
Circus, yes.
In that basement.
I know.
What do they do?
So I can get aerial in there. And
no.
I get a pole in there. So I've got a pole dancer, an aerialist.
Wow.
It's an A-frame, so it's not fixed, so it's great.
Okay. Wow.
It's very interesting trying to get it down between acts, but, you know, we've been doing it. another circus, I've got a hula hooper.
Yeah.
I've got a girl who does acro, who does all bendy stuff with her body. It's all slightly insane. It's actually my sister. Keeping it in the family. Yeah, my little sister.
Wow,
she's
I always didn't realise.
Yeah, she's seen my shows for years, and she's like, oh, I want to be in your shows.
She's always been bendy then, is it?
Insane. It's
she's
almost,
bendy.
It's almost
how
like,
insane is
well,
bendy?
She can stand there and just lift her leg up
yeah.
straight without even holding it.
Yeah,
I know,
that
yeah.
is insane.
I mean, I wouldn't
yeah.
even
is,
try.
This is going to sound terrible. She's bendy and firm.
Yeah.
She was rock solid and amazing. So, you know, slightly scared. How does she do that?
It is mad. Yeah. And she gets her head at like a foot by her ear.
He's definitely pleased, isn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, you know, I mean, she is a very pleased. She's one of my residents now. She's fantastic.
Right.
And it's nice that it's my sister, so.
Excellent.
Nice family show.
Yeah.
get the dad involved now.
So what do you do in this wonderful show? Are you...
So I host and sing in the show.
Okay.
So we open the doors at 6:30, so I'll do a little bit of background singing just as people are coming in. And then I'll host the whole thing.
Right.
And basically, if anyone's... wanting a shout out or celebrating, and they let me know, and I give them a little bit more attention, introduce the act. So we've got burlesque there, beautiful burlesque, classic, neo-burlesque, circus, as I mentioned, and then I'm the cabaret.
Wow.
But it's going to be different hosts. I won't be hosting all of them. I want to retire and sit at the back and drink Prosecco whilst watching my work. That's the dream.
In a big chair.
Get a bit on,
This is all mine.
Yes. I'll sit there stroking my cat.
That sounds brilliant.
But so we'll be having loads of different performers, different shows every week.
Yeah. That sounds brilliant. Sorry.
He's on it.
I'm excited.
I'm pleased. I'm coming.
You definitely have to.
Definitely. When is it?
We have male performers as well.
Oh, yeah.
Boylesque, yeah. So it's a real mixed variety show. It's great.
It's very bright and I love the colours and the
quirky,
feel.
Quirky, it's fun.
It's a great venue. I've been to it a few times. It's lovely.
Really lucky to have it. Yeah, it's great.
So is it going to be a regular thing?
Uh-huh. So at the moment, we're just doing like a slow build-up. So we've got this Saturday, and then we've got the 12th and 26th of October, the whole of November. December we haven't. We're leaving that. Bit mental, December.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
And then as of January next year, it'll be every single Saturday night.
Wow.
And originally,
every single Saturday night from January.
Every Saturday of the year.
Okay. Yeah.
It was aimed at originally for hen parties and big groups.
Yeah.
But actually we've been getting a lot of couples coming, date nights. You know, it's really lovely.
Sounds
and
fun.
It works.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I say it works. I don't know. I think it's great. I'm so biased.
It works.
Is there a connection between that and the classes you run at all?
Well, no, actually, one of my girls that I taught but now performs for me, Allegra Rose, she started doing my courses. I can't take full credit for her because she was a dancer already.
Okay.
But the confidence that she got from the yeah, exactly. I just helped her. She had it in there. I just helped get it out. Right. So the courses are great. We're running them at the moment. My next big show for that is the 19th of October at the Old Market. So we're at the Old Market now. It's massive. Right. It's just the girls are happy they've got a changing room because before I've been shoving them in the cellar, so they're like, oh, that's fantastic.
You're spoiling them with changing rooms.
Behind the scenes, I know. Great, it's so good. So it's just constant shows all the time. I'm like, wake up every day, who am I today and where am I?
Ah. Wow, it's brilliant, nice though.
Yeah, but showless, we really want that to do well, so. Meal options as well, I think it's good value. It starts from £25.
Yeah.
So you can have a show only, just come in, £15 show only. But hopefully next year we'll be too busy to allow that, so everyone has to come and eat. And the food's so good there as well.
Oh, right.
It's really good food, yeah. So £25, you get a platter and show. £30, main course, drink and show. £40, three-course meal and the show. So really good value. And it's a club night from 10 onwards, so you can stay in the venue and dance and party. And
what kind of music is the club music?
It's all sorts, actually. I was what day is it today? Monday. So Saturday night he was playing.
No. Technically it's Thursday.
Oh, Thursday. I'm confused with my day. See, I don't know who I am and what I'm doing, whatever day it is.
Join the club.
So last Saturday was they were playing everything, literally, from. Yeah. That's how good it was. That's how much I remember. I had quite a lot of vino that night.
So what's the age?
We were dancing anyway.
Is there any age limit or any? Anybody any age can
go. No, you'd be allowed in.
No,
it's
I'm too old.
It's all right.
I can't get down the stairs.
We'll get you a carer. You'll be all right. It's like, you know.
Carry you down.
Yeah.
Just over 18s. There's no age limit.
Yeah.
Of course not.
Right.
The older, the better, I say.
I could just get there.
Yeah, you could, yes.
I'm just turned 19.
I might do an OAP discount.
Thanks,
I'm not sure. I don't even know how old you are. I'm just joining on the bandwagon.
Yeah, I'm 74.
Oh, really?
No.
Oh. Yeah, somewhere around there.
No.
Somewhere around there. I look good for 74.
The boylesque side of it, because this is the thing, because like, I recognise people in the audience and so on, and they're very Brighton people.
Yeah.
It would be, Andy. Like, well,
yes,
Brighton.
Okay, yes. which it always amazes me how much the showlesque, the whole burlesque thing, has taken off in Brighton.
Like,
how welcomed it is, how exciting it is.
Yeah, definitely,
How's the boylesque part of it going down?
The boylesque is my favourite part because you don't expect it.
So if you've
Boylesque.
It's a boy.
I thought you were boylesque. Oh, right, that's good. See, I should come along.
I've used that for
education.
Male performer, yeah. It goes down well because no one expects it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the main boylesque I use is Dave the Bear, absolute legend. He's fantastic on and off stage. And he's just so funny. And it's just really fun, light-hearted humour, what he does. I mean, I can't even explain it. He does things where he strips down and puts water over him and he pretends he's all fabulous. And
so it's obviously a man doing it. It's not like a drag thing. It's actually a man.
No, but I am wanting to get drag involved as well, actually. I think drag is so popular down here.
Definitely, yeah.
And I think it would work in the show just to have a real good, strong mix of all sorts. Something for everybody.
Definitely, gosh.
one of your colleagues, Tori, the fabulous Tori Tequila.
Tori Tequila, one of my girls, yeah.
Yeah, I know she does this thing where she dresses as a man and does a male stripper.
Well, I had her in the show. It went down so well, yeah. I won't spoil it, but yeah, she strips down and it's just hilarious what she's done with herself.
The thing that makes it...
What's hanging out?
Her Stormtrooper one as well. It's hilarious.
Spent years
the helmet doesn't come off.
Yeah, she did.
Absolute years, yeah. She's a good egg.
She
helps with the show as well. Sometimes she helps with us with the door hosting and what have you. Mm.
So how does it feel to have made such an impact on the city?
You know what? I didn't want to brag.
But
I actually won an award. I won a Burlesque Hero Award, being the most influential and inspiring person on the scene.
How
lovely is that? I should have brought it so I could just have it around. So basically all the girls, there was this awards and they all voted me and I won.
Wow. What was the award? What was it? There's a trophy?
A little trophy.
Oh.
I know.
Well
really,
deserved.
Really nice.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Yay.
No, I can't take credit. I've literally just given a space to a load of people and they all make lovely friends and they just have a lovely time.
Yeah.
I just get them in.
That sounds perfectly natural.
I'll take out a link to the last interview where you listed the benefits of doing burlesque,
which is
really quite impressive.
Yeah.
We're entering the last minute of your interrogation.
I feel like you two should do a double act at my show.
Oh, God.
We could do, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be interesting.
So long as he wears that shirt, that's fine.
Just this shirt.
I really like the shirt.
Please more.
Thank you.
I think it works, yeah.
You and Debs.
Why me and Debs?
You guys are more funny than us. Anyway, move on.
So, last minute. When's the next show?
I mean, there's only so many things you can talk about when it involves
seven
naked people, isn't it? I'm being so PC, I can't talk as much.
No, 28th of September is your next show.
28th is the next show. And then there's two in October and all of November.
Brilliant.
Thank you very much, Veronica, and thank you for joining us. Tune in next week because we promised the XR they're going to come in and have a chat about their stuff. And we also are hoping Hush Beats Disco will be in as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.